And so I'd like to invite Nicolas for the first statement on how you see it from an extractive industry perspective, which I think is the, one of the industries that, if there's an industry that already has a good geopolitical muscle, it's definitely the extractive industry. But I think there are many other industries that can learn from you. Over to you.
Thank you, Nicolas. Good afternoon, everyone. First, let me say it's a pleasure to join this panel and to share a few comments on how a company like TotalEnergies is managing geopolitical risks, international risk. And I'm going to start with that, and after I want to make a few comments on how we see some opportunities in international trade and investment, and finish with a few comments on energy transitions in all this. So TotalEnergies, you know, is a French company, so we are born 100 years ago in a country where there is virtually no oil and gas resource. So from the very beginning, we had to go abroad, you know, work in different countries and learn how to manage geopolitical risk. And you know, when thinking about how we do that, I came up with five or six key principles. The first one is about compliance with our values. And our first core value is the security and the safety of our people. And it's impossible for a company to send a lot of people abroad in challenging environment if you know you don't ensure their safety and their security. So we have golden rules, we have a safety framework, we learn from experience, and this we apply everywhere. Similarly, one key principle for us to navigate into those risks is to always stick to our compliance principles and ethics principles, no matter what is the country, what is the context. And obviously, to comply with international sanctions when they apply to our activities. So that's principle number one, compliance with our values. Number two, it's pretty obvious, is diversification. So the company is working in 130 countries. We, you know, we like to diversify the way we allocate our capital. We've set a principle for ourselves that we don't allocate more than 10% of our total capital employed in one single country. For upstream investments, our upstream investments, they are scattered between the Americas, the Middle East, Africa, Europe, Asia-Pacific. I think the biggest area for us is Middle East and North Africa, which is a bit less than 30% of our total production. So we diversify. Similarly, when doing our transition and investing in integrated power and renewables, we make sure that we also diversify the allocation of the capital, and we also diversify investments between deregulated markets and regulated markets. The third principle is we like the exposure to liquid markets. Of course, oil, the oil market is a liquid market. When you produce oil, you know the oil goes on a tanker and can be supplied to any country in the world. For gas, it's a bit more complicated because gas relies on heavy transportation infrastructure. For gas, we focus a lot of our investment in liquefied natural gas, which offers this flexibility on this exposure to a liquid market. You know, for liquefied natural gas, you can redirect the production from one country to another. The first one is about supply chain resilience. In this moving world that is getting more and more fragmented, we are careful to continue working with a wide array of contractors from different locations. And of course, the geographical footprint of the company helps us to do that. We tend also, you know, to develop long-term frame agreements with our contractors to provide visibility and to provide security of supply in a way to both sides. The next one is about cost discipline and financial strength. We are in our industry exposed to high volatility of prices. You know, the oil price can go up and down from $20 to $100. So this we don't control, we accept we don't control that. But what we control is our cost. And Our motto is to produce low-cost energy, which is a key factor for us of resilience and strength. And the strength of the balance sheet, of course, is also key for a company like Total Energy to weather crisis, which can have a pretty significant or severe impact at times. On the last principle is it's not a principle, in fact, it's a principle of action, is crisis anticipation and preparation. So we spend quite a bit of time on identifying and mapping our risks, making sure we have the right mitigations in place, carrying out crisis management exercise based on a number of scenarios. And this is what allowed us, in fact, to weather a number of the recent crises. If I take, for example, the COVID-19 pandemic, we never stopped production in any of our operational sites during the entire crisis. But this is due basically to practice on anticipation and on preparation. The second comment I want to make is that private investment through long-term partnerships contributes to build bridges between companies, between countries. And those bridges, they can, not always, but they can survive a geopolitical crisis. So what we are doing here, for instance, in the UAE, where we have a partnership that we built with ADNOC for 80 years now, where people know each other, where we shared a lot of experience, where we, of course, invested in Abu Dhabi, but also teamed with ADNOC to invest together abroad. This type of bridge or this type of link is very solid, and that's what we try to develop to make sure that our activities are resilient. We have similar partnerships in many countries across Africa, across Americas, across the Middle East and Asia Pacific. We also contribute to or participate or like to participate in cross-border investments. A good example of that is a project called Dolphin, a gas pipeline between Qatar and the UAE, which started 15 years ago. Gas has continued to flow uninterrupted during 50 years, despite ups and downs. I would say our resilience also, or the one way that we use to increase our resilience is integration. In oil and gas, we not only produce oil and gas, but we also supply oil and gas to the people. You take the example of Africa, for instance. In almost all African countries, we have a substantial distribution network, which for us is a factor of robustness because it means we not only produce and export energy, but we also supply energy to the people. And when you bring something to the people, basically, they generally support your activities in a better manner. So, my last comment, I'm watching the time, is that in this changing global trade pattern, one key factor is the energy transition and the need to address climate change. In Total Energy, we believe that our role, our mission, is to provide more energy with less emissions. Why more energy? Because there is a growing population needed more energy, but this more energy, we want to supply it in a manner that is safer, that makes energy available, affordable to the people. And when I was talking about controlling the cost and, you know, of our activity, it's also a way to make energy supply affordable to the people. Less emissions, I don't need to explain, because of course we need to produce energy while reducing the greenhouse gas emissions, particularly for ourselves, the greenhouse gas emissions related to our activities, so what we call our scope 1 and 2 emissions. So by doing this, we are working not on our own, but we are working in partnerships with national oil companies in the countries in which we operate. It's the case here with ADNOC, for instance, where we cooperate on identification on elimination of methane emissions from our operations. We like also to develop multi-energy projects. We have a large project, multi-energy project in Iraq that we started recently, where we develop an oil production, but we also gather and process natural gas for local power generation. And we built a large scale 1 gigawatt solar power generation plant to supply the local communities in Basra area. So typically for us, this kind of multi-energy project is a way to contribute to the transition in a manner that is positive for the countries in which we operate. And it's also a way for us to manage risk and to diversify what we're doing. I'm going to stop there and just to say that, of course, geopolitical risk and the risk associated with our investment is a key parameter in all the investment decision making in the company and in the way we endorse or decide to launch projects.
Yeah, thank you, Nicolas. And I think the point which is also interesting is to see this role, as you said, building bridges and also investing in local communities is, I think, a very important part of avoiding risk, not also from a corporate point of view, but from a societal point of view. Thank you.